That's Mariah Carey, of course. It's a Christmas classic. All I want for Christmas is you. Right, 1 minute after five here right now. You know what it's time for? Yes. Inside the Vault.
What's Inside the Vault?
Time from Inside the Vault then. Monday to Friday, the Vault releases two songs from its archive of music. And it goes on the Facebook page, Sun FM and The Home Run Show as well. We have no control what the Vault is going to release. It has a mind of its own, believe you me. They come on the Facebook page just before 4 o'clock. You check them out and you decide which one you want to hear at 5 p.m. Today's choices, you could have had The Hollies, The Air That I Breathe, or The Who. My Generation was today's choices from Inside the Vault. One is going to get played right now. The other one is going to go back inside the vault, maybe never to be released again. The question is, which one did you vote for? Which one are we about to play?
Get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things they do look awful.
Talking about my generation.
I hope I die before I get old.
Talking about my generation.
Take my generation, baby. Why don't you all fade away? Don't try and dig what we all say. Generation.
So let me kill. That was the clear winner today on Inside the Vault, My Generation, The Who. That means the Hollies, The Air That I Breathe goes back inside the vault. Will it come out again? Who knows? The vault will decide. But we'll definitely have two more songs from Inside the Vault tomorrow. They will be on the Facebook page just before 4 p.m. Make sure you check that out. Now, we were talking earlier about one album do you own that you are embarrassed to admit that you love. Yeah? You know, we've all done it in the past. You bought an album. You really like the album. Not necessarily like the group or the artist, etc., but you like the album for the songs. Thank you very much indeed to Andrew Whittaker, who said that Matt Fretwell apparently has the Foster and Allen's greatest hits.
Hey, brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water's sweet, but blood is thicker.
After 5 here at Sign FM, and the albums that you are embarrassed to admit to are still coming in. Thank you to Adam, who said, I bought a Rick Astley album once. I wouldn't say that's embarrassing, to be fair. Rick Astley was okay. Keep them coming in, please. What album do you own that you are embarrassed to admit that you love?
JoJo dancer, a little bit of thoughts of mine coming out the mind of this midnight rambler. I can't wait till these tunes of mine get me out of this loco jam. Get up on that big stage now, show the world just who the heck I am.
Never think that if it all goes right, you got something that can change your life. Use that moment to show your life.
enough and you just might find it. And there's some around who wanna keep you down, but shawty, don't be blinded. Feeling trapped, thinking that you can't get out of this humdrum scene. Time to turn this thing upside down. Show these people what you really mean. Ever since you lose your mind, could it be the big dream you'll find? No more waiting, cause it's almost time.
Some Afro track, this is Afrojack, The Spark, featuring Spree Wilson on the lyrics, of course. 1995, let's take a look at what's happening on the roads for you.
Traffic and travel.
M1 on South Yorkshire, there is a lane blocked on the exit slip road. Delays northbound at Junction 33. That's because of a broken down vehicle there. Queuing traffic on the A61 Sheep Street, southbound in Sheffield, between the Park Square roundabout and the Surrey Lane junction in the roadworks area there. Very slow traffic on the A57 Mosborough Parkway southbound in Handsworth between the A630 junction and the Cosley Hill roundabout there. Heavy traffic on the A61 Westwood New Road southbound in Tangersley, that's the Wentworth Business Park roundabout. A628 Dartmouth Road in Portmore, Barnsley, busy there as well. Eastbound, that's at the Broadway Traffic Lights junction. Also, traffic congestion on the A629 Halifax Road, southbound in Penistone between the Well House Lane Junction and the Hollywell Swain Roundabout there. A630 St. Tinney Way in Rotherham, busy there as well, outbound at the St. Anne's Roundabout. Traffic congestion on the A630 Rotherway in Rotherham between the Rotherway Roundabout and the M1 Junction 33 Roundabout. Fitzwilliam Road is busy as well, inbound at the St. Anne's Roundabout. A630 Travered Way, busy there as well. Doncaster between the Northbridge Road Junction and the Cleveland Street Junction. Busy on the Parkway going into Sheffield. That's on the A630 between Catcliffe and the Europa Link Junction there as well. Heavy traffic early on the A635 Taylor Road, Doncaster Road is now clear westbound in Barnsley. The same as well on the A638 York Road in Scoresby is now clear inbound at the Barnsley Road Junction there. And heavy traffic on the A638 York Road. That's out of town in Doncaster from the St. Mary's roundabout there. Whew, apart from that, I think we're okay. Nothing on the planes and nothing on the trains. We are all good there. If you know of any problems, you can always give us a call. The number you require is Doncaster 32 77 69. So a new survey today released says that more than 2 in 3 British travellers admitted taking something from a hotel room following their stay. Yeah, I bet we've all done it, haven't we? Nick the soaps and the little bottles of shampoo that you get sometimes. According to nearly 20,000 travellers that were surveyed, the survey revealed travellers take all different kinds of stuff depending on the hotels that they stop in. And the most common thing that gets taken is obviously the towels. Yeah, they're going to be, aren't they? You stop in a five-star hotel somewhere, something really posh. Sometimes it has the name embroidered into the towel. You're going to take it, aren't you? Yeah, you're going to take it. Of course you are. I'm not saying you're not. You are. You're stopping in the, I don't know, the Waldorf Hotel. Or a Las Vegas hotel, something like that, you know. You're going to take a towel, aren't you? For your memories. Anyway, some travellers, however, do take the towels. Also, as well, apparently, some travellers take light bulbs. Really? Why the hell would you want to take a light bulb from a hotel? Seriously, that is a problem. And even batteries out of the remote control as well. Now, look, I'm sorry. If you're taking batteries and light bulbs from a hotel room, you need help, seriously. I can understand the towels. I ain't got a problem with that. Can understand the towels. But the light bulbs and the batteries? No. I ain't getting that. Do yourself a favour. Leave the light bulbs and the batteries alone, okay? Don't touch them. Leave them alone. Simple Minds, Waterfront here at Sign, 27 after 5 right now. I'm glad to say that I have guests in the studio. The guests are two parts of five.
Is yes, it? Right,
yeah, two parts of five of the 48Ks. Afternoon, boys.
How are you all right?
How are we doing, sir? You all right?
Yes, yeah, not bad.
Thank you very much indeed for coming down, by the way. Just to let everybody know, 48Ks, you should know them. They are local to Doncaster. They're going to be playing in Doncaster over the Christmas period. And they've also got a Christmas single out as well, which we have been plugging on this station, which you should have all downloaded by now. And if not, why not? We want to know why. Because it's a great Christmas song. How's it going, Ryan, with the song, by the way?
Really well. Everyone seems to be into it. I mean, on YouTube alone, it's had over like 10,000 hits.
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
It's like amazing, really. Yeah. I mean, far exceeded that expectations for it, hasn't it, really?
We just need now everyone who's viewed it to go and buy it, really.
To go and buy it, to download it, yeah. Can you tell how many people download it as well?
We do get figures eventually, not at the moment.
Yeah.
At the moment, we don't really know.
Well, it's got
standing, so it's nice not knowing as such as that.
Yeah, I suppose it's a surprise, yeah. Isn't it? It's also got as well. It has got a surprise because it's got a surprise in the video because it's got one of our very own that used to work here at Sign FM, but who's no longer here now.
Yeah,
Mr. Right. Simon Sainer.
He didn't do. It didn't take much persuading, to be honest.
I can imagine. Did you have to buy him a few beers?
We had to try and find him a Santa suit that fitted. That was the hardest.
Yeah, he is a big guy, isn't he, really?
Yeah.
I love the video, by the way. It's great. I don't know who came up with the actual idea of that, but I do love the video.
It was our drummer who came up with it and filmed it. So, yeah,
he did well, didn't he?
Yeah, he did very, very well based on that, yeah.
It was great, and it's great to watch. If you've not seen it, get on YouTube, have a look at it, and download the single as well. What have you got coming up for Christmas, then? Because I know you guys are working very hard through Christmas. Are you going to be playing here in Doncaster as well through the Christmas period,
yes,
aren't you?
Yes, we're playing at the Leopard on the 20th of December.
Yeah.
That, which is Mad Friday next week, so that'll be mental. And we're in Sheffield on the Wednesday the 18th. The Green Rooms as well.
Oh, good venue.
Yep, so if you're about, then pop down, come see us.
Excellent, so you're actually working on the Mad Friday?
Yeah, afraid so, yeah.
Wow.
And yeah, so are you, though.
Yeah, well, yeah, I am, yeah.
Be a few shandies involved.
Of course, without any shadow of a doubt. You were working, was it last week at, or you were at the Donnydome, I do believe, was it last week?
Yeah, with Remnant Makers, back in November. That was really good, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, great gig, wasn't it?
It was brilliant, yeah.
More like that would be nice next year. Hopefully we can kick on from...
I'm sure you can. What have you got lined up for 2014? Anything in the pipeline?
We've got a few bits and bobs in the pipeline. We've got a few confirmed. We've got a few here and there in Doncaster and Sheffield again. But we've probably hopefully have a few festivals in summer. We've got stuff just to be confirmed. So there's quite a lot in the pipeline.
Nothing that you can say too much of?
Not at the moment. We're still waiting for bits and bobs before we can advertise.
I have. No, that's fine. That's no problem. We've been asking everybody a question today on the show, and it's been quite good, actually, because people have actually come out and admitted some stuff. And the question that we've been asking is, what album do you own that you are embarrassed to admit that you actually do love it? Have either of you two got an album at home or, a particular something on your computer that you listen to and that you actually do like? You know, you're embarrassed about it, but you do like it. Anything at all?
I can't think of anything. I'm sure everything I've ever bought has been amazing.
What? It's been amazing. It's been legit.
Yeah.
I think I had a few of those, the Now albums, like the early
ones. Yeah? Yeah. Now?
I think Steve, our guitarist, is the one with the... I think he's got Best of Black Lace. I'm pretty sure.
Seriously?
Seriously, we have that as when we're driving to away gigs.
Yeah.
That's what we put on in the car. Amongst other things.
I tell you what, you need to find that out if he does or not, and we can just rip him. We can absolutely rip.
He won't be bothered.
He probably wouldn't. We've had people today that admitted having the A1 album. Remember the group Mel and Kim, Des O'Connor's Greatest Hits. I would never admit to that.
Greatest Hits. I couldn't name one of them.
Got more
than one.
Do you know what? Neither could I. To be quite fair.
Mel and Kim, I think respectable.
Yeah, respectable.
I'm struggling after that. Yeah. To be honest.
Foster and Allen's Greatest Hits.
Again, I'll be struggling.
Right. I'll be struggling on that one, definitely. And what else have we got here? The London Philharmonic Orchestra's album. Well, you can't name anything on there because it's just musical, isn't it? Just music and nothing else. Right. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to play your Christmas song because we've been playing it on the show. I'm playing it to death.
That, yeah.
Yeah, no problem. I've been playing it to death. I think it's great, and it'd be great to get it into the charts as well. We'd love to get that into the charts. It is because you know the thing. thing is, when I look back at Christmas songs, and even like over the last few weeks getting the Christmas shows ready, it's the same old Christmas songs. It's the Slade, the Merry Christmas, it's the Mariah Carey, you know, it's the same stuff. Nobody seems to be coming out with anything new.
It seems to be, it's because the market at Christmas is saturated with X Factor and reality shows. So there's no real old school, like Slade or, you know, in the old proper Christmas tunes, which is what we wanted to try and spring back. Back slightly, I would say,
And I think, you know what, as well, I think X Factor will struggle this year.
Hopefully.
Yeah. I think they'll struggle.
I think people are getting a bit fed up with it, aren't they?
Yeah,
I think... they have these campaigns to get whatever to number one, though.
Yeah, definitely. We should have a campaign for the 48Ks to get number
one.
That'd be nice. It'd be nice, though, wouldn't it? Shall we do the song?
Yes, please. Yeah.
Okay, it's called Happy Christmas Day. Here we go. I love it. Somebody yesterday, well, this is, we played it yesterday on the show, and I'm just looking for the message. Love the 48Ks Christmas track, downloading it now. That was yesterday. That was from Gemma Hunter yesterday on the
show.
Thank
you very much, Gemma.
So, well done, Gemma. Thank you very much indeed for that. Great track. Happy Christmas Day. Available now to download.
That's correct, yes.
So, go on YouTube, have a look at it, have a look at the video as well. It is available to download. Please, please, please download it. It's a great song. It's a fun song, and it'd be great even if we just got into the top 40, the top...
Anything.
Just into the charts. Just to get there, wouldn't it? Would be great.
79p.
79p. cheapest chips.
Just gift for everyone.
Yes, cheapest chips. Easy as that. So when is the next gig then? Is it the Leopard or the one in Sheffield?
It's the Green Room. It's next week.
Next Wednesday.
And then our last gig of the year is Leopard on Friday, which we do one every year at Christmas, and they always tend to be probably our best gig of the year.
That's probably going to go with a bang.
Bang one. We'll see how it goes. It depends how late we're on, really. But it's always like a good festive atmosphere, so yeah. Hopefully it'll be a good one again this year.
Excellent. Well, listen, guys, I wish you all the very best with that.
Yeah, and thank you for having
with the song, no problem at all. We've just been saying that they started on that in July, apparently, didn't you, with the song?
We did, yeah.
Yeah, sort of fed up with it now. But not fed up if it gets to the charts.
No, not at all. No.
Definitely not. Well, listen, guys, thank you very much indeed. Wish you all the very best for that. I will get to come and see you guys, definitely, without a shadow of a doubt. Because I remember when we did the biggest show ever with Simon, the second time you guys came in.
A few times in
And it was great. That was a great night, by the way. We absolutely loved that.
From what
I can remember of it, anyway, it was a really good night, that. Listen, guys, have a great Christmas, great new year. All the best with the single, and give my love to the rest of the guys the band as well.
Thank you very much, Mark. Thanks for
having us. Alright, that's 48 Ks. Thank you, guys.
Thanks, mate.
FM 102.6 and online across the world, signfm.com. Many thanks to the 48Ks there. And if you haven't seen them, go and see them. They are great live, seriously. Don't forget to download the single as well, okay? Right, nearly time for me to go. We've got time to do this, of course. TV Guide. And tonight then, BBC One at 8 o'clock in Holby City. 9 o'clock tonight, Last Tango in Halifax. The BBC News at 10 tonight. Panorama at 10:35 tonight, all in a good cause. BBC Two tonight is MasterChef The Professionals. 9 o'clock tonight, BBC Two, Pilgrimage with Simon Reeve. Hepburn tonight at 10 o'clock, and then it's News Night at 10:30 tonight with the Paxman. Important game tonight, it's live UEFA Champions League. Kick-off at 7:45, Manchester United versus Shakhtar Donetsk. ITV News at 10 o'clock tonight, and then UEFA Champions League Extra, the highlights from earlier on. 8 o'clock tonight, Channel 4, it is Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners. Vintage store owner Sarah from Cambridgeshire has much clutter, and she has filled sheds, a gazebo and much of a house with a hoard of stuff. Volunteering to help Sarah is OCD diagnosed Louise, who cleans daily for 8 hours and wipes the floor handles in her home hundreds of times a week. Meanwhile, forecast analyst Adam visits Lara in Rochester in Kent and discovers her property hasn't had a deep clean for 12 years. My words. 8 o'clock tonight, Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners. 9 o'clock tonight is Heston's Great British Foods. It's all doing fish and chips tonight. It's a brand new series. Here's One Clever Guy. Masters of Sex tonight at 10 o'clock. Channel 5, it's the great Christmas toy giveaway tonight. Marlene Klass and Sam Nixon and Mark Rhodes present a 2-hour extravaganza in which one lucky viewer will win a huge haul of prizes. The Mentalist on at 9 o'clock tonight. And then at 10 o'clock, it's Castle on Channel 5. Yeah, basically, that's what's on your top 5 channels tonight. Pretty tame for a Tuesday, I know. And the rest is all free view, because you know what it's full of.
A room full of sadness, a broken heart, and only me to blame for every single part. No science or religion could make this whole. But never love, to have but never hold. It's a life alone and a desperate need to be held, to be loved. So this is gonna take a bit of getting used to, but I know what's right for you. Fly. Take a bit of getting used to, but I know what's right for you. Let me go. A head full of madness, a nowhere safe. When tears aren't big enough, our love turns into hate. It's a life alone and a death. Gonna take a bit of getting used to, but I know what's right for you. Fly.
Fly high, let me go,
let me go.
That sky to, but I know what's right for you. Let me go.
Mr. Barlow, let him go indeed. And it's time for us to go. We've got to get out of here. Main news on the way, followed by the Sign FM Community News Bulletin as well. And coming up at 6, it's Dan with the Rhythm Blitz Show. It's 8 o'clock tonight. It's the Dave Watson Show. And reminisce at 10 o'clock. All those shows to come here at Sign FM 102.6 and online across the world, signfm.com. Thank you very much indeed for your company today. We are back tomorrow from 4 p.m. with more tunes, more from Inside the Vault as well. Watch for those songs going up on the Facebook page tomorrow before 4. And loads of other chit-chat and news and gossip as we normally do throughout the out the week on the show. In the meantime, enjoy the football tonight and catch you tomorrow from 4. I'm out of here. Bye.
FM and online at signfm.com. It's time for the national and international news.
South Africa has been saying farewell to Madiba.
Long live the spirit of Nelson Mandela, long live!
World leaders, royalty and celebrities turned out at the memorial service along with thousands of members of the public who packed into a 90,000 capacity stadium.
I feel so happy to see the other people who come to visit the other country.
Yeah, for me, it's one opportunity of a lifetime.
The US President Barack Obama delivered an emotional tribute.
I will always fall short of Madiba's example. He makes me want to be a better man. He speaks to what's best inside us.
During the service held in the pouring rain, boos were heard for the current South African President Jacob Zuma during his address. In other news, the founder of a French company that sold faulty breast implants across the world has been jailed for 4 years. Jean-Claude Mass has been found guilty of fraud after his firm PIP sold implants containing substandard silicone gel, causing many to rupture. Equalities Minister Maria Miller has announced the first same-sex weddings in England and Wales can take place from March the 29th. The date is several months earlier than expected. Sir Bradley Wiggin says he'll be training for the next Olympics tonight, despite being knighted by the Queen earlier. He says he was overwhelmed to be at Buckingham Palace.
I can't remember what she said or what I said. You know, it's probably more nervous going up there and doing something like that than being an Olympic final.
He was honoured for services to cycling after a brilliant 2012. And Justin Bieber's visited young survivors of the deadly typhoon which devastated the Philippines, urging his fans to help. He's described the visit as the most touching of his life. The singer handed out shirts, toys and basketballs to children. That's the latest. I'm Barry Weir.
You're listening to the Sign FM Community Bulletin.
Hello, this is Arnold Tiege reporting from Nuffield Health, Fitness and Wellbeing Centre. Today we'll be talking to Ian Parkin. Ian, why is Nuffield Health so unique?
The centre's unique because, unlike any other gyms in the UK, we offer a joined approach to health. And what I mean by that is each one of our members receives a health MOT where we look at 12 areas of your overall well-being, and from that we can ascertain your current overall well-being and then work with you to improve the areas that need improving, and to back that up and to give it motivation, we encourage you and reward you to get healthier. So at the end of a health MOT, you'll get a score out of 100, and what you look to do is improve that score. And when you do that, we'll reward members with a free month, personal training sessions, guest passes and other rewards. So it's a bit of a motivation to get healthier. For most people, they usually have a couple of things out of range, and generally speaking, exercise is the answer. So the fact that we can do that on site, we can take blood on site, we can give you your readings there and then put you in contact with the wellbeing fitness trainers who then can go through your results with you and then develop programmes individual to you to help you on the road to better health. And we would do that by using the large gym area the 60 classes we offer each week, personal training sessions, and obviously the swimming pool, sauna, steam and spa. So an overall rounded approach to health. We also have on site nutritionist and physiologist and physiotherapist. So if there's any kind of ailment that needs further sort of investigation, then we can put you in touch with them and work with those experts as well to get you to full health as possible. So the fact that we are a registered charity means that all the profits that are made in the business via the 31 hospitals, the 65 health clubs, the 200 corporate gyms and other services that we run, all of the profit is reinvested back into the business. So we're continually reinvesting in health facilities and medical research and anything that's kind of related to that part of this industry, really. We make our sites as affordable as possible, but we do not compromise on service levels, cleanliness and safety. Those are the three things we get right every single day.
If we could go down to talk about the health MOT which you do for new members, yeah. You could say in detail what comprises of this health MOT.
We look at the three key areas that we really look at are blood pressure. That's a big indicator to your current health. Cholesterol, which is obviously called the silent killer. If your cholesterol levels are high, it could be hereditary, it could be lifestyle. So we give you feedback on your current cholesterol readings. Blood glucose is the third and probably one of the most important ones. That's the one that kind of gives you an indication whether you might have diabetes or not. And obviously, again, sometimes it's hereditary, sometimes it's just lifestyle changes that we need to do. But then we also look at sleeping. We look at musculoskeletal history. We look at caffeine. We look at smoking. We look at sort of heart rate levels, body mass index, which is how much sort of body fat you're carrying and how much muscle you're carrying and whether that proportion's right. Through all of those, you get the full picture of your current overall well-being rather than just am I fit or not. It's a real detailed look at your current health. It takes about an hour to actually undergo that assessment in a clinical environment, but also very relaxed. And you can also have a chat to the guys about nutrition and anything else that you might be affecting your current lifestyle and why you have the health status you currently have.
How could people become members of this wellbeing centre?
It is a private club, so like I said, we do all of those things sort of via a membership. So for around about £8-9 a week is what the average person pays to be a member here. We give you full access to all of those facilities. It's a private members club, so you pay a monthly fee, like I said, around about £9 a month. And for that, you get full access to the gym, full access to the swimming pool, all of the classes. We also have a creche, physio, bar on the site, and the health MOTs are also included in that. So you'd get a health MOT within a couple of weeks of joining, and then we bring you back in for another health MOT after 3 months, because what we're always trying to do is improve your scores, and then we keep regular in contact with you. So in terms of being a member, it's very simple. You know, it's like joining any other type of facility, really. You kind of either make the phone call or you walk into the club and we show you around and we take you through various different membership packages, because we not only just do your kind of standard year-long membership, we also have short-term memberships for 3 months as well, depending on people's personal circumstances. We always recommend that people try the facilities first. We quite often offer a one-day pass, so you can come in, use the facilities, talk to us, get a feel for ourselves and the club, and then see if you really like it.
Is there any particular number or any specific number where people could ring up to get engaged apart from walking in to the centre?
Yeah, our telephone number is it's at Doncaster 01302 365588, or a lot of people actually can inquire through obviously the internet these days, so it's very simple. You just type in Nuffield Health, then it'll ask you to select the gym you want to go to, and it'll give you various bits of information about all the things we've discussed. So you can actually on there select to have a tour of the facility. So we will then just contact you and arrange a convenient time for you to come in and make sure there's someone here to show you around the facilities and get you started.
You're listening to the Sign FM Community Bulletin.
This is Arne Ortega from the Sign FM News team. Today with us is Holly Mason, lead blood donor project, the NHS. Holly, what's this project you guys are doing, blood donation and organ donation, all about?
Every year we find that in the run-up to Christmas, because of people's busy schedules and other priorities, we find that actually fewer people come forward to donate blood. And we still need to obviously supply the hospitals with the blood that they require over the Christmas period and into the new year. So we're really at the moment just encouraging those to please don't forget to give blood. And if you haven't given blood before, now's a great time to start.
So what's the importance of this call for the people to donate blood and all that?
We rely completely on volunteers to give blood. So it's really important that we get our message out there and that people do respond and do go along to give blood. Because if they don't, then it simply just wouldn't be there for the patients in the hospitals. And it's used for such a variety of things, from during cancer treatment, during childbirth. So it's used for a lot of different things, and people really need this blood over Christmas.
The actual process of donating blood, how does it work?
We have lots of donation sessions across the area. In Doncaster in particular, we have the racecourse and the Keep Moat. So we have sessions coming up throughout the end of November and in December. So if someone wants to give blood, the best thing for them to do is to register. They can either do that on our website, which is blood.co.uk. We also have a donor helpline that they can call, which is 0300 123 2323. And there they can register, they can book an appointment, they can find out the session times, and then it's just up to them to go along on the day. So it's quite simple and straightforward, really.
How long is this process?
The donation process itself will take anywhere between 5 and 15 minutes. But because of all the health checks and the rest afterwards, the whole process will probably take between 45 minutes and an hour of someone's time.
So you actually do some checks before taking the blood from that person?
Yeah, so our priority really is to ensure that the blood that we take and give to the patients is 100% safe. So what we do is every time a donor attends a donor session, they'll fill in a donor health check, which just asks them questions about any medication or travel. So we need to make sure that it's okay for the donor to give blood, and it would be okay.